Okay, so let's consider this illustration of evaluation of a salesperson of a ski company. Okay, so that we understand how sales representatives are evaluated, okay, using the different basis of evaluation which we learned in the previous slides, like output factors, input factors, in input factors, quantitative input factors, and qualitative input factors. So for the purpose, the products of the company are divided into two line product lines: equipment, which includes the skis and the ski accessories, and the another product line is clothing, ski pants and parkas. Now pay attention to the target markets. Okay, so this company's target markets include a sporting goods stores, the general sports stores. Okay, so I hope most of you also might have visited sport stores to purchase football, shuttle, badminton, carrom board. Okay, so they are sporting goods stores. Organized retailers in Hubballi are like Decathlon. Okay, they maintain equipments of a variety of sports goods. So general sports goods stores, general there. They maintain many equipments of many sports or many sports goods, different sports goods. And another target market is specialty ski shops, who sell only merchandise related to skiing sports. They don't sell equipments or goods related to other sports. So students, this target market is clear? Two target markets.
Yes, sir.
One is general sports goods stores, which sell a variety of, which sell goods for a variety of sports, and specialty ski shops who sell only merchandise related to skiing sports. Okay. So you have seen the images now, so you will have a fair idea of what the products are. Okay, now company uses own sales force. Okay. And other information is salespeople are paid travel expenses plus a straight commission of 5% on sales volume. So company uses own sales force, and the salespeople are paid travel expenses plus a straight commission of 5% on sales volume. Commission means incentive. In India, we call it incentive. And there are three sales representatives which are located to three different sales representatives. So the sales territory, Rocky Mountain region. This sales territory is assigned to Joe Jackson. The territory of a Pacific Northwest is allocated to Gus Dean. And the territory of New England is allocated to Paula Burns. Okay, so I hope the situation is clear here. Okay, this is an illustration, a hypothetical company. For our ease of understanding, okay, they have taken only three sales reps and three territories. Okay, so now this is how, okay, over a period of time, let us say year. So how these each sales reps have performed, that information is presented here in this slide. Okay, so this is their performance for the whole year. Okay, so all the three sales reps performance. Yeah, what you can see here is first Joe Jackson. Okay, so these three columns belong to Joe Jackson. Okay, who is allocated to the territory of Rocky Mountain region, to the Pacific Northwest, Gus Dean is allocated. So it is his performance. And to the New England region, Paula Burns is allocated. It is her performance. Okay, so now let us dig deeper into this evaluation. Okay, so this is creating trouble now every time. Yeah. So I won't be able to move the cursor closer here. Or maybe I can, okay. So this is the product line. Okay, so this is product line, equipment and clothing. So I told you for the purpose of evaluating the performance of sales representatives, the products of the company are categorized into two product lines. So one is equipment, skis and accessories, and other is clothing, pants and parkas. So the performance of Joe Jackson, if you consider, out of the total sales, 400, okay, the sales figures are in thousands. Sales figures are in $1,000. $1,000. So for the first sales rep, Joe Jackson, out of the total sales, $480,000. $480,000 sales have come from equipment. And $720,000 sales has come from clothing, that is the pants and parkas or jackets. Okay, so this is product wise evaluation. Then if you consider his performance based on the target markets, okay, so sporting goods, okay, he has sold $320,000 worth merchandise of equipment, skis and skiing accessories to sporting goods stores, and $160,000 worth equipment to specialty ski shops. Okay, so this is how you can find out. Okay, when it comes to clothing, he has sold $440,000 worth clothing to sporting goods stores and $280,000 worth clothing to specialty ski shops. Okay, so if the company is using a mobile phone app, okay, or a website wherein the sales representative keep on feeding data with respect to the orders taken, so automatically these result sheets can be generated, huh? Remember. Okay, then okay, when we consider the total calls made by Joe Jackson is here in the last column, 900 it is. So it is 900. Okay, so out of these 900 calls, he has made 500 calls to sporting goods stores, 400 calls to ski shops. Total orders taken by Joe Jackson. Yeah, 1 minute. Huh? I think for him. I'm sorry. It is here. Not 900. I'm sorry. Please pay attention. There is a correction. So the total number of sales calls made during the year by Joe Jackson are 700. Third column, sorry, 700. Out of 700 total sales calls made by Joe Jackson, 300 sales calls were made to sporting goods stores and 400 sales calls were made to ski specialty ski shops. Okay. Then total number of orders taken by Joe Jackson are 500 during the period of evaluation. And out of 500 orders, 150 orders he has taken from sporting goods stores. And he has taken 350 orders, okay, from specialty ski shops. So total days worked, okay. So Joe Jackson has worked for total 220 days in the evaluation period. And total expenses incurred by Joe Jackson on the travel or on the job are $48,000. Total miles traveled, instead of kilometers, it is mentioned total miles traveled by Joe Jackson are 60,000 miles. Okay, so total market potential. Okay, total market potential is in $1 million. Okay, total market potential for equipment is $2 million and for clothing is $4 million. So total, total potential in the territory of Joe Jackson is $6 million. Okay, so I hope you can understand. Then, yeah, this target or potential split into product wise, target market wise, sporting goods stores has $1.6 million, okay, dollar potential, and the specialty ski shops have a $0.40 million. And with respect to clothing of $4 million potential, $2.4 million potential is from okay, sporting goods stores and specialty ski shops present $1.6 million okay, potential are for clothing. Okay. So then, if you look at this, some of the output factors and the input factors. So these all were output factors. So whatever sales volumes we consider product wise, customer wise, or total sales volume. So whatever I considered, okay, you should you can recall, okay, that they were, okay, the basis of these were output factors used as a evaluation basis, like sales volume in dollars. Okay, yes, units is not considered, in dollars we saw it. Sales volume by products and sales volume by customers. Okay, so you saw it, okay, on your own, how this sales volume is used as a evaluation basis in our illustration, and it is an output factor. Okay, so now let's move on to other information. So that is average order. Okay, so total number of total order value divided by total number of orders taken. Okay, so it's 2400 dollar. Okay, so total 2400 dollar. Then batting average. Okay, so batting average, if you can recall. Okay, so these are the quantitative input factors that we are using now. Call rates, days worked. Okay, we saw Joe Jackson has worked for 220 days. So it is a quantitative input factor which is considered. Calls per day or call rate, we definitely are going to consider. So direct selling expense, yes, we have considered. $48,000 expenses are incurred by Joe Jackson. So which is again a quantitative input factor. Okay. So we're here, batting average. Okay, so the overall batting average is 0.714. It means per customer visited, okay, he's able to make sales or take orders to the extent of 0.7 or 70%, you can call it. Okay, then calls per day, our call rate is 3.18, total number 220 calls divided by total number of working days, right? Then miles per call, per mile traveled, how many sales calls he has made. Okay, then 86, that is, then expenses per sales dollar. Okay, so for every expenses per sales dollar, okay, so it is a 4%. Okay, so for every $1 he has taken, he has 4% of that he has spent as an expense. Okay, then commission earned, okay, is $68.57. Cost per order is 96. Okay, so this way, again, it is further split. Total percentage of market, 24%. Okay, so total percentage of market, clothing 18%, and overall 20%. So his sales achievement is equal to 20% of the overall market potential. So this information was about one sales representative, Joe Jackson. Okay, same way. Okay, so the performance of Gus Dean is also evaluated using the output factors and quantitative input factors. Okay, so I think qualitative input factors are not considered here. Okay, so that would require another method of rating. Okay, so once a sales, okay, now what is the sales manager's job? Okay, there will be a sales manager who will do this evaluation of the performance of sales representatives of the company. Okay, then once the evaluation of the performance of individual sales rep is over, okay, so this information is communicated to the sales representatives. Okay, generally one-to-one. And based on this, the sales manager also makes certain decisions, like for example, okay, based on commission, okay, like incentives or promotions, if any, okay, or increments to be given, if any, okay, or warnings to be given, if any, terminations to be made, if any, okay, or reposting, okay, or modifying the territory size, okay, various decisions are made on the basis of such performance evaluation. Okay, so what are the major observations and what decisions are made by the sales manager after going through the performance appraisal or performance evaluation of these three sales representatives? That we are going to learn in next class because it will take some more time. Okay. So any queries for the time being? 3 minutes are still remaining. So about Colorado Ski Company, the product range, okay, 3 sales reps and the territory allocation, then the performance of Joe Jackson, what we just considered. If you have any questions, you can please ask.
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. See, sales manager job, okay, it will include a lot of paperwork also, remember. Not just making a field sales calls along with the subordinates. Okay, so this is where managerial skills will come into picture. While, okay, there are 2 good sales reps, okay, both are performing equally well, okay, and a company is considering to promote one among them as area sales manager. So whom they will consider? Okay, who has exhibited managerial skills? Okay, selling is different from managing, huh? Remember this. Okay, that's why actually MBA colleges started to develop more managers to meet the growing need for managers or growing demand for managers from the company. But remember, unless you learn, put them into practice, read a lot, okay, and have a goal for your career. These I tell semester 2 students, I have come out with a new phrase, 3-7-10, 3-7-10. If we don't learn them and if we don't practice them, okay. So MBA is as good as 3-7-10 and 3-7-10. So who will tell what is 3-7-10? What is 3-7-10? You cannot say, I don't know. MBA has become 3-7-10. In some other university, it might be something else. 5-5 or 10 plus 10. Yeah, what Nandan says is right. 3-7-10 are marks. If there is no career goal, no intention to work, or no intention to professionally manage a family business, or no intention to start a new business, then what is MBA? MBA is for 3-7-10. But anyway, I'm sorry, I should not say this. But anyway, I just skipped out of my mouth. I'm sorry for it. So students have started quitting already. Very good. From 27 to 18. Very good. Class is not yet over also. Okay. So thank you everyone for your respect and kind attention to the class. So I'm going to end the meeting now. Okay, so you can log out, and happy lunch hour for all. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.